cyclone and removes all the clouds in your akasha. That's what happens. All the clouds which is there in your chitakasa, they are just driven away by this vibration. It acts like a cyclone. That's why the vibration does so soothing and so beautiful. Yes, yes, yes. You are supposed to be aware of all the sounds. Birds chirping is also a Veda mantra. So, let everything enter into you. All right. Now it is time. I think whenever I tell time only, you understand the time. You know, there is a sloka in the Guru Gita. Guru is called as Kalagala. Kalagala means two things. One thing is the Lord of Yama. And one more meaning is the eater of, swallower of time. In his presence, you don't feel time. All right. Now you will have, how long you want to take? 45 minutes. Okay. 9:45. Okay, 9:45. For your speed, they cannot come. Yes, you can recite in the house.
Morning.
Yes, morning. And if you don't know how to recite and all, just play someone cassette. You will be given all the major mantras, the cassettes, in the gift pack itself. In the pack itself, you will be given. Just put the cassette and continuously let you listen. That's more than enough. The thoughts clouds will be driven away by this cyclone. The boundary feeling will be lost. That's the beauty of the mantra. So actually, the mantra is coming out of a person who doesn't feel the boundary. So the same feeling has to happen in you. The same feeling has to happen in you. It's like a gunpowder. Put on your being. You also experience the boundaryless state. Because you feel boundaryless only, you feel so nice to sit. See, one thing you understand, when the shoe fits, leg is forgotten. When the belt fits, belly is forgotten. When the chain fits, neck is forgotten. When the body fits, boundary is forgotten. So, let us gather for next session. If you have done some mistake, some wrong, some blunder, and you feel deep guilt, the guilt becomes a wound, energy black in subtle body. So when you leave the planet Earth, you decide, I have to come down just to relive properly. Many people want to leave the college life once more, just to relive properly. Relive. Last time, whatever mistakes I did, I will not do this time. Just to relive, you want to live once more. Are you able to understand what I say? That is what I call blockage of guilt. Blockage of guilt. Basically, our guilt will start at the age of 7. The first guilt will be the layer of sex. Then one by one, the next guilt will be guilt given by the social laws. The third guilt will be guilt which you yourself create based on the social laws. After some time, you don't need society. You yourself master the art of creating the guilt. First, the guilt which is created based on the sex layer. Next, the guilt which is created by the social law. Third, the guilt which is created by yourself. Unless you come out, work on the layer of guilt, you will not be able to rest or relax peacefully without body. Just to relive or redo the whole thing, you will have to come down. If you have the deep wounds of guilt, be very clear, it is much more powerful than desire. Desire will pull you to enjoy it. Guilt will pull you to redo the whole thing. if you are given one more chance to live, if you think you will live in a developed way, in an improved way, then you will come down to live in a so-called improved way. Now, let us understand about guilt and let us start bringing out all your guilt outside. Then we will have more insights on the guilt. First, start from the young age. Whatever guilt was killing you, forget about it. Is killing you, write about that. There are few guilts which was there, but now it will not be there. You would have forgotten. It would have been healed. Then it will not be there when you leave the body. But which is there even now in your being? Go deep. Go deep. Scan your whole life thoroughly. See step by step. Whatever guilt still haunting you, still disturbing you, bring it out. Right. Just feel the whole situation and bring the whole thing out and write. Let the guilt be brought to the consciousness. If you remember, write. If you have forgotten, it is gone. As long as you remember, bring it out. No. Any from there to till this moment. If you have come late, you may be having a small guilt. I came late. If you don't feel guilty of that now, if your logic, if your reason is not getting hurt, if your mind, if your consciousness is not getting haunted or hurt by the guilt, forget about it. If you feel little haunting, if you feel little hurt, being hurt, then bring it out in writing. And don't show to anybody. Start. Anything you feel, bring it out. If you don't have faith that somebody will read, then bring it out in the language only which you understand. That's what I call Mullah Nasruddin's language. Somebody, there was announcement. We need a person who knows how to read and write French. Nasruddin said, I can write but I cannot read. The manager was shocked. You can write but you cannot read. Strange. Alright, let you write. He wrote. And nobody could understand. Then manager said, read what you have written. He said, I told you already, I can only write, I cannot read. I cannot read. I told you that. So write in that French. Writable but not readable. Start. It is just for yourself you are bringing it out. Not for anybody else. Go deeply into that emotions, into that time, into that being, into that space. That is the main thing. Please be very clear. Go deep. Wherever you had guilt, go deep into the situation. Even if it is small regret, right? You can. Regrets are nothing but guilts. Whatever is there, just like a wound in your being, bring it out. Write with full emotion. Don't just mention. Relive the whole thing and bring it out.
find out dark corners of your being, find out everything and bring out, bring all the process out. If they are related to guilt, then they are guilt only. If they are related to pain, we will be working on pain, let us work on that. Pain is one more layer. We will work on the pain layer next. We should work on the guilt energy. Again, guilt is an energy. Of course, low energy. Let me explain one thing mainly. Guilt is nothing but the place where you rest and regenerate your prana sarira. Please be very clear. If you don't have guilt, you cannot have desire. If you don't have desire, you cannot have guilt. Desire is like you are just tensing your whole body, your whole being to have something. Once you are tensed too much, once you have reached the peak, no other way, you have to relax a bit and rest. When you relax a bit and rest, the low energy, you feel something uncomfortable in your being. So all your old worries jump on you. It's like your worries take revenge on you when your hormones are in low. Please understand, when you achieve some desire, when you work towards some desire, almost all your system, your whole nervous system comes to a peak, comes to the totality. Your whole being is alive. Naturally, you cannot be in the same tune. Sari, Gama, Pada, Ni. But in Ni, you cannot stay for a long time. How long can stay for a long? How long can stay in the Ni itself? You have to come down again. Come down. When you come down, when your energy becomes a little low, the worries, small worries, which was there in one corner, they all just jump on you. That is what we call guilt. It's nothing but because of your weakness, even a small dog barks at you. Once you become a little weak, even a small dog can bark at you. Worries are guilt as such as no positive existence in your being. They are just the negative existence of energy, that's all. If you work towards the upliftment of energy, naturally the guilt will not be there. Guilt is created only from Mooladhara and Swadhisthana. Between that space, Mooladhara and Swadhisthana, in that space only, guilt is created. If the energy is not let to stay in that space, naturally you will see, you will never fall in guilt. If the energy is lifted from that space, you will never fall in guilt. Before that, before the alchemy work, we will work on your guilt. Anybody who has got a deep wounds, something you want to open, you can share. I'll try to give some insight. Insight means how to go beyond it. What's the other side of view or outsider view? I can say insider view. Anything. Whether outsider view or insider view. We'll try to work at your guilt in a different angle. Look at your guilt in a different angle. Anybody, deep wound which is not going, which you are not able to heal by yourself, which you need the help of me, you can come.